Hi everyone. We have been on the real-time clock since the last videos. We will conclude that today with the alarm clock. Building on the program in the last video, add to the menu block the alarm minute with a max of 59 and min of 0, and the alarm hour with a max of 23 and min of 0. To save the value of the alarm minute and hour to the EEPROM, add a new board and drag in two value of the menu item blocks. Set the first to get the menu value of the alarm hour. Add the second to get the menu value of alarm minute. Drag in to save in EEPROM blocks. Double-click on the first and create an alarm hour variable with a starting EEPROM value of 0. And the second with an alarm minute variable and a starting EEPROM value of 1. Then connect them to their respective menu blocks. Drag the set tag, a falling edge trigger block, and a timer as shown. Connect them together and to the EN inputs of the EEPROMs. Change the timer to a timer off delay with a delay value of 3000 milliseconds. To activate the alarm when there is a match between the set time and the actual time, add another board to the program. Drag a read from EEPROM block into the program. Double-click on it and choose the alarm hour variable. Insert another block with the alarm minute variable chosen. Then insert the alarm clock block. Choose the clock number and select the hour and minute. Connect the EEPROM reads to the respective inputs of the alarm block. Drag in the set tag. Invert its output and connect it to the EN input of the alarm block. Then add a digital output assigned to pin D2 with the name buzzer and connect it to the alarm output. To show the alarm set time, add a board below board 4. Copy the blocks from board 4 and paste them here. Change the comparator I2 input constant to 3. Delete the RTC block and insert a read from EEPROM block. Double-click on it and choose the alarm hour variable. Insert another block with the alarm minute variable chosen. Drag in an additional string converter block and draw connections between these block pairs. Change the first display data constant to alarm time. Deselect the second display to center and select column 1. Insert a string concatenation block with 4 numbers of input. Connect its output to the input of the display. Right-click on the first input and insert a constant string of hour and a colon with a space after. Connect the second input to the first string converter block. Right-click on the third input and insert a constant string of min and a colon with space before and after. Finally, change the upper limit constant of the counter in board 1 to 4 and upload the codes to the ESP32. When the menu up button is pressed, the time, date, temperature, and alarm time are shown on the display. Hold down the menu buttons for about 3 seconds to enter the settings mode. Set the correct minute, hour, date, month, and year. Also set the alarm minutes and hour. Press the menu up and menu DW buttons to exit the settings mode. When there is a match between the set minutes and hour and the actual minutes and hour, the buzzer will start sounding. The buzzer will stop sounding when 60 seconds have elapsed. And so, we have an alarm clock. Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit the like button if this video is helpful, and see you in the next one.